ग्लोबल ई स्पोर्ट्स, वेलोसिटी गेमिंग, डमारू, सॉल्ट, एक्सेली, एक्सप्लॉयट, एनिग्मा, क्रैश लैंडिंग, दीज आर सम ऑफ द टॉप टीम्स प्लेइंग एट वैलोरेंट कॉन्करर्स चैंपियनशिप बाय नॉर्डविन गेमिंग. द इवेंट इज एंटर इन टू प्ले ऑफ फेज ऑफ दिस मॉर्निंग एंड वी आर ग्लैड टू शेयर दैट वी हैव विद अस वन ऑफ द टॉप स्टार परफॉर्मर्स ऑफ वैलोरेंट इन इंडिया. इज कॉल्ड गणेश गंगाधर. ही इज ऑल्सो नोन एज एस के रॉसी. आई एम दीपक. And you are watching VCC Interact with Talk Esport.
Hello everyone, my name is Ganesh Gangadhar, also known as SK Rossi in the esports scene. I play Valorant for Team Global Esports and I also like to stream and upload gaming content on YouTube. Other than that, in my free time I like to listen to music and I'm a huge fan of anime, so I watch a lot of anime.
Thank you, Rossi, for introducing yourself. Thank you so much. Now we'll begin with the questioning sessions. I have some of those which we get from our analysts, we get from our fan pages, people write to us. So I'll start with the first question which I have in mind. How do you handle the pressure, the expectation the people have with you, like from the fans' perception? People are spamming SK Rossi in the chat all the time. You are playing, the camera's on you, the broadcasters and observers are focusing on you. So how do you handle the pressure?
No, it doesn't add any pressure to me, but instead it helps me to play better and it keeps me motivated every single day. And I feel like giving my best in every game I play, because if my fans are giving me their time by watching my streams or tournament games, it's my duty to perform well and entertain them in every game I play. And I also carry their dreams with mine. So I'm really happy that my fans support me.
Apart from being a good player, you also might agree to the fact that having an analyst or a coach or an IGL in a team is a very important factor which most of us miss out. And Indian teams have not been very receptive of it lately. So do you think with growing the scene in India, and how do you see the role of IGL or analyst being played in the coming future?
In Valorant, I don't think you should be depend on one guy to make the calls entire game. You need five flexible individuals that can adapt on the fly and make calls for the team. And since the game is new, I don't think you also need a coach when you as a team can sit together, make things work out, make new strats and discuss what works and what doesn't work for you. So it's like five brains working instead of one or two. So I think IGL, it shouldn't be like only one guy who handles the entire thing. All the players should be smart.
The VCC South Asian event is just around the corner, the main event, the finale, for which SK Rossi has been practicing all this while, and the best performance is preserved. Even though you are the top player in India, even though people have seen you play in almost all kind of domains, all kind of pressures, do you still think there is a team in India which can come across as an underdog or could catch you off guard? Or do you think teams like Velocity or Enigma, who are among the top few, do you think they can give you a performance, or they have read all the tricks of your playbooks?
No teams, to be honest. Our playstyle or our mentality when we approach every game or every tournament is to be prepared for any team that comes against us, put us in any kind of situation. We just keep adapting as a team, keep communicating and win as a team. So, I don't know, we are just prepared for everyone.
Speaking of statistics, it has come to our information, and I'd like to bring it to you as well, that a website called VLR.gg, which independently scrapes data of Valorant games, they have rated you as a top player for Valorant in the region, and this region which already has millions of players. You being at the top of the table does give you a sense of credibility and authenticity that you have been doing great. So are we to assume, or are we right to assume, or not wrong to assume, that SK Rossi now would breach the boundaries of the nation and try to test his skills elsewhere in the Asian region or the rest of the world?
I think players should be more creative and grind hard to reach the level of regions like, let's say, NA or EU or SEA, because players out there are first individually very strong and they are like lot focused, they are really smart. So to reach that level, I think we also should play a lot of games, try to learn the game in No, every game we play and figure out what's our strength and weakness, what we have to work out, all the stuff. But and also as a team right now, what we do is we just watch the games of NA or EU and just copy strats or take whatever that is good, and we try to understand it. But again, since we are not trying to do anything like by our own or not trying to add new stuff, so I think we should be working on making our own strats which will, you know, suit our play style, and we should start thinking more creatively and bring our own game style. Actually,
we have seen many duelists fail to transition into meaning yet. Players and experts across the globe have often emphasized on the fact that a correct mindset is needed in order to adapt the skills of Jett above all else. So as a professional player with a lot of experience, how do you see this?
I think you can use Jett at full power if you're really good at operator and really confident in your aim and making your decisions, which helps in getting the initial kills or by creating the space in the map where you can help your teammates to move around easily by creating the space or getting those entry frags, making it 4v5, release the pressure out of them. And to do all this, you also need to be really skilled, and you need to be, you know, your communication should be on point, seeking help from your team, and basically you need to do everything with the team. So I think teamwork is pretty much needed.
And anything in general SK Rossi wants to tell to its fans? Any message, any expectations, any aspirations do you have? Any inspirational words for your fans do you want to tell them on how should they play or how should they not play, or what to expect from SK Rossi at the event?
Thank you fans for supporting me since the beginning and being with me in my ups and downs. Trust me, I'll do my best and be loyal in whatever I do in my life. And I know you guys will support me throughout this amazing journey, and I won't let you guys down. Show your support also to other players and all the teams out there who are working really hard to be the best, to represent their country and win tournaments. So you guys should also, you know, come and watch all the tournaments and show your support to the teams who are participating. And no hate to anyone, because everybody is fighting for their dreams and everybody wants to represent the country. So yeah, we all want your support, and I love you guys.
So I guess this is it. This is the end of the discussion before the playoffs begin. SK Rossi, I'm glad and thankful that you chose to be on the show, and you have answered all your questions with utmost sincerity and honesty. I wish you all the very best for your games ahead. This is DPK for Talk Esport. See you soon.